Hello, my dear children and parents. Welcome to Indus Valley Public School RAT, class 8th, where we were doing lesson number 7, and the name of the lesson was Our Visit to Cambridge from Honeydew Book. This lesson is written by Firdaus Kanga. Children, before we proceed to our video, I'll just review our second part video from this lesson. So, my dear children, as we know, this lesson was the meeting of two greatest people, that is Stephen Hawking, he was a greatest scientist, and Firdaus Kanga, a writer and journalist from Mumbai. They were physically abled in different manner. They were disabled, but they were very good in something or the other. So, they both found amusing when people praise them, that we have studied in our second video. This thing happened when there was a interaction going between Firdaus Kanga and Stephen Hawking. A number of questions were framed and put up in front of Stephen Hawking by Firdaus Kanga. In the mean of, or you can say in between of conversation, Firdaus asked, yeah, Firdaus told that sometimes people, normal people used to think that people who are disabled, they are unhappy. Then on that, they both found amusing when people praised them. Stephen said, yes, when the author asked about his annoyance on being disturbed by a person like him. Author was taken by the first look of Stephen as he looked like a skeleton. The writer asked Hawking's opinion about the best thing about being disabled. The reply was negative. So Hawking said it's not good to be a disabled person. Others' admiration of Hawking's living could not console him. Then the writer asked him about his advice to the disabled people. He advised the disabled to concentrate on what they are good. They should try nothing beyond it. They must not be over enthusiastic. Then the writer narrated his guitar's incidents. At last, the writer saw Hawking's big garden and then he wheeled out. The writer found his journey successful and inspiring. So children, this is what there in the second part of the video we had discussed earlier. Now coming to the summary of the lesson. This is a story of a meeting two disabled people. Both are extraordinary in their fields. Stephen Hawking is a great scientist, though he suffers from paralysis. He is confined to a wheelchair and he can speak only with the help of a computer. Firdaus Kanga, the writer and journalist from Mumbai, was born with very weak and easily breakable bones. He too moves around in a wheelchair. He meets Hawking in England. The two had discussed how the so-called normal people should look at the disabled. The writer Firdaus was on a walking tour through Cambridge to UK. His guide told him about Stephen Hawking, who was occupying Newton's chair at the university. But Hawking was a disabled fellow. He wrote A Brief History of Time, one of the best sellers. Firdaus phoned Hawking that he was from India and wanted to meet him and write about his travel in Britain. Hawking agreed to see him for half an hour. The thought of meeting somebody like him in a wheelchair gave Firdaus courage. Both of them were disabled. Their bodies were disintegrating. Hawking had a little switch in his hand. He was able to move his finger to find the words on his computer. He felt exhausted very often, but his mind was brilliant and bubbling with thoughts. Firdaus marked that people often thought that disabled people were unhappy people. Hawking said that it was an amusing attitude. He admitted that. He felt annoyed when another disabled person came and disturbed him in his work. The body of his case was just a box of brilliant mind and soul. He did not see anything good about being disabled. Seeing the poor condition of the great scientist, Phidias felt great relief, even though he could neither walk nor even stand. Hawking did not like the idea of the disabled Olympics. He thought that it was a waste of time. His advice to the disabled people was that they should concentrate on what they are good at. Hawking made Phidias spend 1 hour instead of half an hour with him, have tea, and see his garden. He went about in his motorized wheelchair. Then the time came to depart. Phidias got up to take leave of him. He could neither kiss Hawking nor cry, but he was convinced that the paralytic scientist was a symbol of bravery. So here we end with the summary. Coming to the question answers of the lesson, first we'll do the comprehensions. Which is the right sentence? Cambridge was my metaphor for England to the writer. So Cambridge was a reputed university in England, or England was famous for Cambridge, or Cambridge was the real England. So second option is correct. The writer phoned Stephen Hawking's house from the nearest phone booth, from outside a booth, from inside a phone booth. So correct option is first one. Every time he spoke to the scientist, the writer felt guilty because he wasn't sure what he wanted to ask. He forced the scientist to use his voice synthesis. He was face to face with a legend. Second option is correct. Fourth one. I felt a huge relief in the possibilities of my body. In the given context, the highlighted word refers to. So here, shifting in wheelchair, turning the twist, standing up, walking, speaking, writing. First option is correct. Now coming to the working with the text. So answer the following question. First one. Is the prospect of meeting Stephen Hawking make the writer nervous? If so, why? Yes, the writer felt nervous because he was doubtful whether he would be granted for interview or not. Question number two. Did he at the same time feel very excited? If so, why? He felt excited at the same time because he had been there to see Professor Hawking for half an hour. Guess the first question put to the scientist by the writer. The writer's first question might be about Hawking's disability and how he had accepted it. Next question. Stephen Hawking said, I have had no choice. Does the writer think there was a choice? What was it? Stephen Hawking said, I have had no choice. Yes, the writer thought that Stephen Hawking had a choice. Living creatively with the reality of his weakening body was a choice. Next question. I could feel his anguish. What could be the anguish? Professor Hawking's mind was full of great ideas, but he could not speak them out clearly. And it is difficult to find the right words on his computer. So he felt frustrated and tired. What endeared the scientist to the writer so that he said he was looking at one of the most beautiful men in the world? The thing that endeared the scientist to the writer so that he said that he was looking at one of the most beautiful men in the world was Professor Hawking's one-way smile and his frankness. Without being sentimental or silly, he declared that he was annoyed when somebody came to disturb him in his work. Next question. Read aloud the description of the beautiful man, which is the most beautiful sentence in the description. The line is, before you, like a lantern whose walls are worn so thin, you glimpse only the light inside in the incandescence of a man. Next question. If the lantern is the man, what would be its wall be? The wall of the lantern is Hawking's case where he's skeleton like physical structure, or you can say it is the what is housed within the thin walls. The glow of eternal soul was housed within the thin wall of his body. Then question number four, question number seventh ka A, you can also write the wall of the lantern is the Hawking's body, you can say, in other words, or you can write the same answer. What general conclusion does the writer draw from the comparison? The writer draws conclusion that eternal soul is more important than the body. Next question, what is the scientist's message for the disabled? Professor Hawking's message for the disabled is that they should concentrate on what they are good at. It is foolish to try to copy the normal people. Next question, why does writer refer to the guitar incident? Which idea does it support? The writer spent many years trying to play a big Spanish guitar. One night he loosened the strings joyfully. This incident supports the idea that the disabled people should practice only what they are good at. Next question. The writer expresses his great gratitude to Stephen Hawking. What is the gratitude for? The writer expresses his gratitude to Hawking for inspiring and giving him strength and confidence to be brave and to be creatively. To live creatively. Next question, that you will do by yourself. Complete the following sentences taking their appropriate part from the boxes below. So you will be doing it yourself. First one is there. There was his assistance on the line. So which is the correct option for here? You have to get. So two options here, there. Tapping at a little switch in his hand. So what will be the correct option? A and B. You will match it out. You will do by yourself. Okay. Now, working with language, you will do in book by yourself. I'll explain. So here some words are provided to you. Fill in the blanks in the sentence below using the appropriate forms of the word given in the following box. So I met a dash from an antique land. So here are the words. You will fill the words in this blank. Okay. Next, looking at the following things. So here the words are given, a read session. So you have to frame a phrase. So a reading session. Then smile face, so a smiling face. Similarly, you will make others' phrases also. Okay. Next question, use all or both in the blank. So here five questions are there. Wherever two things are there, that time you will put both, and more than two you will put all. So you will do by yourself this question also. So here are the blanks that you will fill by using all or using both. Next question, number four. Complete these sentences using the right form of the adjective given below. So what are the different forms of adjectives? So here degrees you are going to use, like fast, faster, fastest. Just recall, where two things are there, comparison, then ER is used. When more than two is there, comparison, then EST or most is used. Okay. For example, my friend has one of the superlative degree. T se start hota, da se start hota. Okay. So already da is given. So what do you will write? My friend has one of the fastest cars on the road. Now this is the dash story I have ever read. So interesting. So interesting, you will not be able to make change the form. So you will write da is there. So this is the most interesting story I have ever read. Similarly, you will do with others. Okay, children. So here I end with the video. Complete your work and do send me the things. This question, no, working with the language, you will do in the book itself. Okay, rest you will write in your copy. Okay. So children, just complete your work. Go through the video. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.